Good morning, YouTube. few things I was going to talk about, and I forgot all about them. I don't even remember what not. Anyway, the weather is getting bad here. I woke up today. Well, let's start with yesterday. Yesterday was payday at work, and I was pleased. I get paid every week, and it was actually more than I was expecting. Man, I was like, oh shoot, because the boss came up to me and said, "Hey, after work, I need to talk to you." I was getting ready to turn in my time, and he said, "No, after work, just come in and talk to me." Okay. So then I was worried all day long for the rest of the day. It seemed like it just drug out because the boss wanted to talk to me. I'm new and I'm trying to do my best. I'm not going to say... I thought I may have set the bar too high for me. But anyway, the end of the day finally comes, and he calls me and he says, shut the door. I said, okay. So here I am freaking out. So I shut the door, and he sat me down and explained some stuff to me and about how I was going to get paid. And everybody out there is on salary. And they started me out, you know, low. But he hands me my check and explains to me, I turned in my hours and explains to me on the salary I was on. He explains that to me. He said, okay, you work this amount of overtime. So this minus this equals this. Okay. So he ended up making up the overtime his way, and so I got a check, a little bit of extra, and then he handed me an envelope, and I said, "What's in this envelope?" And he said, "It's a surprise. You're supposed to you open it in your truck when you're going." So anyway, the short time that I was in his office. He made me an offer. I wasn't going to turn down. So instead of the overtime thing at so much, he raised my weekly salary, which makes it to where... Well, I mean, I know it's salary, but it'll equal out to $2 more an hour. I've had a $2 raise. But he said, the only thing that I expect of you is you owe me 2 hours a month. That equals out to what he wanted to pay me an hour. So I owe him 2 more hours a month. That's it. For a $2 raise. So I give him 2 free hours, and I got a $2 raise. Can't beat that. And if I work Saturday, he pays me. He pays me for Saturday. And he said, I'm going to do this because the paid holidays and everything else. And I'm still in my stinking PJs, and it's a Saturday. The first Saturday I haven't worked in a long time because of the weather. So, with that being said, I am so sorry, but the box is loaded. But don't know if I'll make it to the post office today. If not, it will be when I get done at the salt mine on Monday. And I'm sorry. I'm so sorry I kept it this long. It's all ready to go. All my add-ins are in there. And like I say, if I don't make it up there today, then I'm gonna try. But if I don't, then it'll be about, hopefully not. I'll have it at the post office by 9 o'clock on Monday morning. Whenever I'm done at the salt mine. But you saw my add-ins and whatever, and I've added a little bit more. I'll keep that and just let them show you at the box opening. But I imagine the box opening, if he shows all the tobaccos, it's gonna take a long time. Yeah. Cool. But anyway, that's that. And I do apologize for the delay on it. Next, Pack the Bag Piper. I have some stuff to send off to you. Here was the tin. It was open, and I had smoked a bowl out of it. And I don't really care for it. But Squadron Leader is now, it was open, so now it's empty. If you want the tin, I'll send the tin along with you. It's a Pack the Bag Piper, but it is in this jar that I got conveniently from Danny Shore. He's just sending me jars. It's a plastic lid, not the best of jars, but it already had a Squadron Leader thing on it, and then it had about the tobacco right here. Don't know what this is, so ignore this. But yeah, Sam McGowath Squadron Leader. It's a Squadron Leader right there. Okay. So if you want the tin, I'll send the tin along with, but it's in a mason jar because it was opened. So there's that. Alright. And I will add to that. First of all here, I'm not first of all, I've already been doing stuff here. We're into the video. I cannot put my finger on this, Jaime. It is awesome, but Zombie Blend out of my PSP. It's good. It really is. It's a, I want to say medium strength. Little bit of nose burn because I retrohale quite a bit. But there's no tongue bite, no anything. It's just good. I don't know how to explain. What it tastes like to me. Well, I know it goes good with coffee. It may be a little strong for the morning, but like I said, it's burning good. It tastes great. So, whoever got the box and didn't try the Zombie Blend from your boy Jaime, says right on the bag, your boy Jaime, you're missing out, or you missed out already. This stuff is good. And then also Scotty's butternut. Can't remember. It's Scotty's butternut something. And you open that bag, and it actually smelled like a. Like if you were to go buy a butternut squash, it smelled like that. It was great. I actually loaded I reloaded the Hacker with that, and in my Joe Case Stubby Poker, I have, let's see, I got it in the jar there, Beverwick, good stuff, Jaime. I'm enjoying it. I'm gonna set it down. As everybody knows, my contest has ended. I gotta check my email just to make sure nobody sent another one before time was up. But there are 5 pictures now posted on Instagram. I have them on there. I have your YouTube names on there. And hopefully today, possibly, I'm going to shoot a video with my computer showing my phone, or having Missy won't get on, my fiance won't get on camera, but you'll see her hands, they're all prettied up, orange fingernail polish. Orange. She used to always wear purple. She bought an orange one. So, she'll be picking. And, we'll find out. So far, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At least six different tobaccos going in. I see one more down there that I'll put in as a surprise. I got one right there that I'll put in as a surprise. But these will be samples. They'll be 2, 3, 4. There'll be at least 4 samples. 3 unopened tins. 1, 2, 3. I'll just send the rest in that mason jar of one of them. Because I got plenty. So I guess it'll be 3 samples, a mason jar almost full, and then 3 unopened tins of tobacco. Big old baccy bomb. But we are coming up on the 15-minute mark, actually 14-minute mark, but Daniel Shore, thank you for posting the video, let me know it got there safely. I'm sorry that the tape didn't hold. I only had a little bit on there, and he threw a little extra on at the post office, and I got there early. He said it was supposed to be there today, but smoked the heck out of that thing, and like I say, I'm in no hurry. Just as long, you know, I figured you need your name on the list, being such a good friend to me and to the community. Smoke it as long as you want, and get your name on that sheet. Looking forward to your video. I posted all those on Instagram, and here I have it all popping across the top of my phone, but we're coming up on the mark. So Pipe Smoker Stu wishing everybody an awesome weekend. Smooth Smokes Zombie Blend, folks. Peace out, YouTube.